What's up, guys? This is Soundwave Jordan here, and we are back once again with another video regarding Transformers Bumblebee the movie. And of course, we are going to be talking about some juicy news today. And I gotta admit, this completely threw me off by a landslide. I did not expect this to happen, but hey, it's happening, and I'm all up for it. As you guys already know, the franchise is pretty everywhere at this point, and you know, I enjoy it regardless. So as you guys can clearly see from this title and the title of the video, the image you guys see in front of you, John Cena, that's right guys, John Cena, the WWE superstar himself, the "you can't see me" meme, he's actually joining the cast of Transformers Bumblebee. That's right, John Cena is joining the cast of Transformers Bumblebee, and I was thrown off. I did not see this coming at all, but I would like to assume that Travis Knight, Paramount, Hasbro, whoever's in charge, pretty much Travis Knight because he's a director, I would like to assume that they know what they're doing and they have a very smart position for him when he's going to be joining the cast of this movie. So let me read this article to you guys and I'm going to give you guys my thoughts and opinions and whatnot right after I'm done. So let's get on with it right now. John Cena joins Transformers Bumblebee. Plot details and new release date announced. WWE superstar John Cena has joined the cast of Transformers Universe Bumblebee, according to Hollywood Reporter. The site also reveals the plot synopsis and revised the release date for the movie. The story is set in the year 1987, where Bumblebee finds refuge in a junkyard in a small Californian beach town. Charlie, aka Haley Steinfeld, on the cusp of turning 18 and trying to find her place in the world, discovers Bumblebee, battle-scarred and broken. When Charlie revives him, she quickly learns this is no ordinary yellow Volkswagen bug. That synopsis also confirms that Bumblebee will return to his Volkswagen Beetle, aka the VW Bug, vehicle mode from Generation 1, aka G1. The film kicks off production today in California. Paramount has set a new release date for December 21st, 2018, which puts the film opposite Warner Brothers' Aquaman. So I would like to assume the only reason they're pushing the date forward is the fact that they do not want to compete with any of the movies, because as you guys already know, and I had a forum and I talked about it in one of my recent videos, Transformers Last Night, it's pretty much a flop when it comes to the box office numbers. Transformers Last Night failed miserably, especially domestically, and right now it's pretty darn rough. The box office numbers are completely horrendous, and it's actually kind of disappointing, especially for a Transformers film, because as you guys already know, the Transformers films are supposed to be summer blockbusters and they're supposed to have a lot of funding, especially for Paramount. However, it seems like people are coming to their senses and would like to watch a quality film instead of a mindless, brainless action flick. So box office numbers for Transformers Last Night, they're horrible right now, and right now Paramount is doing the smarter move and pushing the release date instead of having it compete with other, you know, summer blockbusters such as Aquaman, as you guys can see right here. So that's pretty darn smart of them for pushing the release date of Transformers Bumblebee. Let's continue with the article though. We're right here. Travis Knight, who directed a stop-motion movie Kubo and the Two Strings, is helming the new film from a script by Christina Hodson, Shut In. Haley Steinfeld is leading the cast of Paramount's new film, which will center on the yellow and black bot Bumblebee. The film will feature a young cast including George Lindenborg, Jason Drucker, Abby Quinn, Rachel Crowe, Ricardo Hoyos, and Gracie Designy. I do not know how to pronounce your last name, but my apologies for butchering it. So let's go back to what we were talking about. First and foremost, John Cena. John Cena, he's joining the cast of Transformers Bumblebee. Now, don't get me wrong, John Cena, he's a lovable guy. He's one of the coolest WWE superstars, and he was one of my favorite, you know, WWE superstars when I used to watch it at a younger age. But in terms of his acting, me personally, I don't think it's the greatest. I mean, it's average, at least in my opinion, but I don't think it's anything phenomenal. But I would like to assume that John Cena, for some reason, I get the feeling that he's going to be voicing a Transformer. If I were to guess, he will probably be voicing one of the Autobots, maybe a friendly Autobot, or maybe a very fun or hyperactive Autobot. I know there were some comments on TFW stating that people would like to see John Cena voice Warpath if Warpath were ever to become a live-action, you know, Transformer, but that's just, you know, fan wishes and all of that. But I would like to assume that John Cena, he's going to be voicing probably a funny character, somebody who's energetic, somebody who's hyper, and somebody that's just like the complete opposite of Bumblebee, or perhaps, you know, one of Bumblebee's closest friends or closest comrades. I don't know. I'm just throwing out some random ideas, but that's what I'd like to assume John Cena will be doing in this movie. I don't think he's going to be acting. I believe that he's going to be voicing, and it's going to be something very interesting, because John Cena, as I mentioned earlier, he's a lovable guy. Everybody likes him. Everybody enjoys his company. Everybody enjoys his presence. And I just feel like him voicing a Transformer, especially an Autobot in particular, will be a perfect opportunity for him to see his voiceover skills rise and shine. So that's just what I think. The question is, who do you guys think he's going to be voiceovering? Did I even sound right? I don't know. The question is, who do you guys think he's going to voice over if he actually voices a Transformer in the film? Leave your thoughts down below. Another thing, however, is the fact that we actually get some new details in terms of the plot of this movie. The plot of the movie is Bumblebee finds refuge in a junkyard in a small California town beach area. Haley Steinfeld's character, aka Charlie, finds Bumblebee, discovers him. You know, he's hurt, he's battle scarred, he's broken, and pretty much Charlie, aka Haley Steinfeld, revives him, and they learn to bond with one another. So this makes me think Bumblebee must have been running from somebody or must have been fighting somebody and deeply got injured for him to be hiding and for him to be quote unquote battle scarred and broken. So this makes me wonder, who is going to be the villain of this film? And that's something I'm really interested in. That I am really interested in who's the villain of this film, because as you guys are to know, during this time of the Transformers live action cinematic universe, the robots are in disguise. So pretty much they're trying to hide from the humans and, you know, not reveal their whereabouts to anybody. However, the Decepticons, they're pretty much, you know, even though they're in disguise technically, they don't really care. They will eliminate their targets, and if that means eliminating Bumblebee, of course they will eliminate Bumblebee by any means necessary. And this makes me wonder, who's going to be the villain of this film? I truly hope that it's going to be somebody menacing, because the fact that Bumblebee has to take refuge in some junkyard or, you know, hide while he's, you know, battle scarred and broken, this makes me wonder that Bumblebee must have feared this Decepticon, and perhaps it shows him becoming stronger, or perhaps this is a turning point in his life where he actually turns to be a strong and powerful Autobot scout that we see in the current movies now. So it really makes me wonder, and I'm really excited for how it's going to be turning out, because like I told you guys many times, this is going to be a clean slate for Paramount and Hasbro and the Transformers community in general. New director, new writers, new producers, just everything's going to be different. We're going back to the 1980s, so we're going to have all those G1 references, and it's just going to be very interesting to see how it turns out, and I'm really looking forward to it. John Cena's joining the cast. We're going to have a menacing Decepticon. I truly hope it's going to be a menacing Decepticon, because I feel like that's going to be a missed opportunity if they don't do something like that. I'm hoping it's going to be one of the returning characters, maybe Shockwave, Soundwave, Starscream, I don't know, I'm just naming some random Decepticons, but I hope it's somebody scary, somebody that Bumblebee fears and makes him have a epiphany that makes him become the strong and powerful Autobot that we see him as today. So I'm looking forward to it. What do you guys think about this? I already told you guys a new release date. It's smart of Paramount to push it forward because, you know, the Transformers last night box office numbers pretty much did something to them and made them realize, hey, we actually have to put quality into our movie if people want to watch it. So that's good. And also, production started today, for those who do not know. Well, yeah, today. So, whew, things are looking pretty darn crazy. I'm pretty darn excited. But what do you guys think about everything I just mentioned? What do you guys think about John Cena? What do you guys think about the plot of the film? Who do you guys think the Decepticon antagonist is going to be? Who do you guys think John Cena may be voice acting if he's a Transformers? And what do you guys think about Transformers franchise in general? What do you guys think about the box office numbers? What do you guys think about the release date being pushed forward? Let me know in the comment section below, because I would love to have a nice discussion with you guys. With that being said though, guys, thank you guys for watching nonetheless. All links will be inside the description. If you guys would like to, leave a follow on my Twitter and my Twitch if you guys would like to see me stream some games. With that being said though, guys, thank you guys for watching nonetheless. This is Sonny Jordan here. Peace, lates, and I'll see you guys in the next Transformers video. Be sure to leave your thoughts down below, and be sure to have a lovely, awesome, splendid day.